Hey, we're here at Yonge and Dundas Square with the leader of the Ontario Green Party, Frank de Jonge. Mr. de Jonge, thanks so much for taking the time.
My pleasure to be here. Thank you very.
Now, you are a leader of Ontario's Green Party, a party that has supported innovations that benefit the environment, obviously, and Ontario residents specifically. What are your thoughts on the low-speed electrical vehicles like Zen or Dynasty?
Well, first of all, we're a party that wants to have a strong economy and a clean environment. So, of course, the connection to the Zen car is a no-brainer for us because there's a lot of money to be made in selling sustainable products. And it's just bizarre and almost obscene that the provincial government does not allow Zen cars on the road in Ontario. They're allowed in 48 out of 50 states in the U.S. and they're allowed in Quebec and British Columbia. So it's bizarre. We make the cars here, yet they're not allowed to be used here. They're totally appropriate. They will, each car will save 6 tons of CO2 per year, and it can be used for anything that you use a normal car for in urban areas.
And you make a great point that now the green technology is so viable now that it's actually profitable. When you see something today like General Motors laying off another 38,000 Canadian workers, here's a Canadian company that's in demand, and do you see a strong future for green products in general?
Well, obviously, I think this recession. I've been around for a few recessions now, and in the past recessions, everyone said, "Oh, we can't worry about the planet now. We have to get the economy going again," and so we had to go gray again and abandon green projects and products. But this time, it's different, Barry. I'm actually thrilled to death that this time everyone is saying the reason for this recession is dirty, gray, obsolete 19th century technology. And everyone is saying that the way to get out of this recession is to go green. That's very heartening for someone who's been trying to say that for the last 25 years. And I think it's so true. People want to do the right thing and they want to go green, but we have to stop the subsidies to dirty technologies like nuclear, like coal, in terms of our healthcare costs associated with coal, and stop the subsidies to the dirty, obsolete car culture, and let's go to nice, clean electric cars. Ideally, we should have very few vehicles at all. We should go to 1/10 of the vehicles at all in our urban areas, and the vehicles that do exist, electric police vehicles, emergency vehicles, mass transit vehicles, should all be electric.
Yes, and as I see you've rode your bike here, so there are obviously low-speed vehicles on Ontario roads operating as we speak.
That's the absolute irony of the situation, because the provincial government says, oh, the Zen cars are not safe. What about a bicycle? How safe is that when you get hit by a 2-ton chunk of steel? Bicycles, in a sense, are not safe at all. And then there's scooters on the road, electric and motorized scooters, which don't have doors at all. So how can you say the doors aren't safe? So it's a ridiculous, I don't know, I'm not a conspiracy-oriented person, but it gets awful close to thinking that the provincial government is so desperate to help their buddies in the dirty, obsolete car industry that they're ignoring and stonewalling the notion of moving ahead with green tech, which is the Zen cars.
Now, as someone, as you said, who's been supporting issues like this for a quarter of a century now, is there almost a sense of a little bit of vindication now that it's sort of coming full circle and everyone's finally cluing into what you've been saying for so long?
Barry, that's right on the knob. I don't know how many times I've run in elections and people say, oh, we love you, Green Party people, but you're ahead of your time, you're ahead of your time. And we're saying, no, we're not, but people didn't get it. And it looks like the issues have caught up with us and the voters have caught up with the Green Party. And so I think we're here now, and it's clear that we are a viable political option and our goal is to be government.
Where can more people find info on the Ontario Green Party specifically?
Well, you can just Google us, www.gpo.ca, or just Google Green Party Ontario or Green Party Canada. There's Green Parties all over the world. We're elected all over the world. The Green Party in Canada and in Ontario is as strong as any Green Party in the world. We will be electing people to our legislature very soon. There's an election in British Columbia right now where we're making good headway. I think the future is bright for the Green Party and for green issues.
Mr. de Jonge, thank you so much for taking the time, and I look forward to hopefully having you in Parliament in the very near future.
I appreciate it, Barry.
Thank you. Frank de Jonge.